Okay, welcome back. Last time we finalized the exterior, and now we want to work on the interior part of our scene. So let's go back to our file with all the assets, and here we are going to work using this bed. So I'm copying this over and pasting it in, and the position seems to be quite good already. Okay. So first I want to delete a few parts like this over here and these two. Okay, I don't want these. And yeah, let's make some edits to this model really quickly. So I'm going into my camera to get a better view and start my live viewer. Let it load. Okay, so let's scale it down a bit so I can see the whole frame so we can make sure that check cameras off, and now we can start playing around with the placement of our bed a bit so we can rotate it. And yeah, what's happening? Okay, so let's go back. Before we rotate it, I'm sorry, we want to hide this part that we don't want. Actually, we do. So you can see that the axis of the object is not centered. So let's go into this child object of the subdivision surface, go into axis and center our axis. So we can now easily change the scale a bit. So I want to make it a bit smaller. And now I'm just trying to fit it under this bed sheet. Okay, I'm not going to edit these polygons. So let's just work with the move and the scale tools. So I want to stretch it a bit and make it longer. And now it's just playing around until I get it right. So yeah, this is looking good. Let's move it up a bit. And as you can see here on the left side, obviously we do not want this, so we are bringing it down a bit again. Okay, moving it. Okay, I'm just speeding this up right now because it's a really boring process, but I just added another cube here and I'm trying to redesign this bed a little bit, and now I'm just changing the position of everything and just trying to get it to look good. And yeah, this is fine for now. So what I want to do is hide our ceiling from the viewport because I think it's a bit annoying to work with. And now we want to add another landscape object, and what we are gonna create with this is our snow. So I'm going to scale this a little bit in this direction. Okay, looking good. Just something like this. And we want to add some more segments. Yeah, we can leave it as it is for now. And what you want to do is add a displacer. So by holding shift, you can just place it as a child and go over to the shading of the displacer and add a noise. And yeah, you can already get the idea I guess. And let's change some settings over here. So I want to use a Voronoi 3 and play a bit with these scale settings. You can just copy these from this video for now. So I'm trying to get something that looks a little bit like frosted snow. So this scale is looking good for me, but our noise has a bit too much contrast. So I'm trying to bring some more values down a little bit. So this is starting to look better. Yeah, but it's too high. So let's go back into our displacer object and change the height. I don't know how to say this in English. It's a bit hard to pronounce. Height. I don't know. It's probably gonna be funny if you listen to this. And yeah, really moving this down a bit. Okay. And rotating it more. Yes. And this is basically how I created the basic shape for our snow. Super fast, super easy. And I think it works for this scene. Okay. I guess we can leave it as it is for now. And let's make a copy of this and place it in the back. Just change the random seed a bit so it's looking different. Okay, and rotate it. So I'm only really looking with my eyes to the left on the live viewer. So I can see where I'm placing it. And let's rename these so that we can keep it organized. All right. And now we want to add a cube. We just want to add a small detail on the edge of our pool here. So yeah, let's just do it like 20 centimeters and 5 centimeters high and place it roughly where the pool is starting. And now stretch it so that it goes like all the way to this wall. Perfect. And yeah, just add a small fillet. So this is just helping us to divide a bit between the pool and our room. And yeah, it's just a small little detail over there. Now let's see our whole frame. Okay, it slowly starts to look like our original reference image that I have created. So yeah. What do we do next? So I want to play a bit more with the rotation of our bed and place it a bit more centered in our frame. Okay. So let's create the material for our snow. Let's rename this and apply it onto our geometry. And now we are going to go into our node editor and do the same thing again. So adding a submaterial and try to make a material that looks somewhat like frosted snow. And to do this, I first want to edit the index value a little bit. Yeah, this is not a realistic value. I'm just doing what I think looked best. So then I added these maps that are in the project files folder 2 called snow. And I'm just setting all my grayscaled materials to float to save some VRAM. And yeah, this is our displacement. Doing the same here with setting it to float. And let's drop in a displacement node. So let's up the resolution here and connect it with our displacement. This is looking super weird, but we are going to fix this. So let's change our height and add a Gaussian blur and blur it a little bit. And yeah, now let's do a render region. So now I'm just adding a transform and scaling it down just so it's a really small scaled snow detail that we have, and adding a texture projection to the other nodes and changing it to box, and then adding another transform node here, and we are going to scale this up a little bit. Okay. So let's go into our material called snow, and we want to introduce another submaterial here, and this will be called ice. Okay, so we are changing the index to 1.7. and add an octane noise to use as a mask between these two materials. And in this noise, we are going to change a few things. So you want to switch over to a turbulence noise and edit the gamma a little bit, bring it down to like 0.54. and give it some more contrast, maybe like 8, yeah. So you can see how our noise is masking between these two materials here. And I'm doing this because I wanted to get a little bit of this dirty snow look. So like when the winter is going to end, and there's not perfectly white and beautiful snow, because our snow is placed in a desert environment and also in an interior, so I don't expect our snow that it would be perfectly white. So I'm adding an RGB spectrum here and giving it a little bit of a bluish tint for our ice color. And as you can see, it's too much saturation, so bring this down a bit. Okay. And now I have to think. So I'm changing these settings for my noise. I think this is looking good. And yeah, you're probably wondering, if a bug like this happens, just restart the live viewer. So you are probably wondering why our snow looks so dark. So we're going to fix this in a minute. First, I want to change my camera settings a little bit. Make sure the check camera is on so you can actually see what you're doing here. And yeah, just playing around with the gamma a little bit here. Okay, and also bring down my LUT strength to like 0.75. Okay. So let's uncheck check camera again and go out of our cam. And yeah, don't worry that our snow is looking so dark. We're gonna fix this in a minute. But first I want to start adding some area lights. So in this scene, I'm using two area lights together with an octane daylight for my lighting. So yeah, let's switch our lighting, our area light mode to texture and bring the power down. And now I'm just rotating it a little bit towards the ceiling. And it's a little bit hard for me to explain where to put these lights. So I'm just trying to make our lighting look a little bit better in certain places here. But these are only placed roughly, so we are going to change these positions later on again. I just wanted to add these lights already. So we are copying this area light and scaling the second one down a bit. So yeah, let's make the second one a little bit brighter. And also turn off everything in the visibility tab. Okay, I know it's looking a bit ugly at the ceiling right now, but don't worry, we are going to fix this later. So in our camera tag, I want to add a little bit of highlight compression, maybe like 0.4. So we don't have these blown out white tones. And yeah, okay. So here I'm just trying to figure out which light is causing this problem on our ceiling. And let's uncheck, check camera. Okay, so I'm just trying to find a better position for this. Okay, for now let's leave the light where it is. We're going back to this later and start adding some details on our walls. First, I want to move our lights down again in the object tree so it's all at one place, and try to organize the object tree a little bit better. So yeah, in this file we have just a cube inside a cloner to have these pillars, and I'm just putting this inside a null, and there's going to be a problem in a little bit, because for some reason you're going to see this. For some reason, I have placed a keyframe, and you just saw that I got confused here why this was happening. So yeah, our cloner just went crazy, and I didn't realize why, because I accidentally placed keyframes for these cubes. I don't know how this happened. So we go to our timeline and just select these and hit delete. And the next step is to move this null out of this cloner, just delete the cloner, and yeah, we're just going to drag these two cubes out of our null and select just one of them and hit Alt-G to make a new null that has the same centered anchor point, so it's working good. And now we are just moving this again to the point where it was. Okay, just bringing my ceiling back in so I can see it a bit better. And yeah, okay, now I'm just moving this up a little bit, and we want to have a little bit of spacing here, because later this is giving us a really small shadow, which is just a nice detail. So it's better if this cube is floating a bit above our ground than if it would be intersecting, just because it's gonna give us a tiny little shadow. So yeah, I am using my copy of the cube and just scaling it down a bit, moving it to the front, just to have a little bit of a more detailed shape for our pillars here. Now I'm just creating another copy, scaling this a bit, and yeah, you can do anything you want here. I was just trying to go with a very minimalistic architecture here, so I didn't want to add crazy details. For me, it was perfectly fine to just use a few different cubes and just have some slight differences in scale, so we can have some small but effective detail. Okay, and this is looking good. And now what we can do is select our null and hold the Alt key and click on the cloner. So this is the child of a cloner object now, and we want to move this here by 300 centimeters. And let's see, okay. Let's make 6 copies of this. And yeah, that's it for this chapter. We are going to continue in the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Tune in later.